This video is made possible by my Patreons. If you also appreciate my content and would like to support my channel, visit my Patreon page. The link is in the description. Hello and welcome to today's video, which is the fifth of the series of the Making a Pochette. If you haven't seen the previous ones, you can have a look here. I will put the playlist. And in today's video, I am going to work on the top and the back. At the outer side, I'm going to make the arching. But before I do that, I need to make a tool like this one, but in the pochette form. This one is to put the top and back inside to work on them. In this way you don't damage the edges. But I need another one that has the pochette shape, of course, because this doesn't work, as you can imagine. To do that, I have two pieces of plywood already here. One is a little bit thicker than the other one, and they are 12 millimeters and 10 millimeters. And I'm also going to make it a little bit different. I'm not going to put this system on it, as it is a lot of work to make it, and I'm going to use it for the time being only on one instrument. I will do it on another way, which is easier and also works pretty good. I will start by screwing the two pieces of plywood together at one side. Now I can use the back to measure the width. And cut it on the bench. This is the center line. This is now the outline of the back, but I have to cut it a little bit smaller, about 1 centimeter narrower, so that the blades don't fall into it, but rest on it. Now I can remove the screws and cut the inner side of the upper part. Afterwards, I cut 4 small pieces of plywood. Fix them on place temporarily. Used the back to mark them. And the drum sander to shape them. Finally, I screwed them on place. The shaping mold is ready. By the way, if you want to know how I made the one for violin, you can have a look here. Now I can go ahead. I will start by planing both the top and back to almost their final height. They are now about 4 to 5 millimeters too high. The top and back are now at almost the correct height. Now I'm going to use this small tool to make a mark between the purfling and the edge to make the groove over the purfling. The groove is ready on the top and the back. Now I can start working on the arching. I don't have the templates, unfortunately, but I have a picture of the side of the instrument, so I can see how it has to become. And I have my small planes ready, so I can start. As soon as I was done with the planes, I started cleaning everything with the scrapers. Okay, the arching is done. It's almost completely clean. I will have to finish it up as soon as the blades are glued on the ribs, just before starting to varnish the instrument. I have to say that as the instrument is very narrow, as soon as you have made the long side, the other side almost makes itself. But as the instrument is very small, you don't have the space that you have on a violin, especially here at the upper side and a bit at the lower side. I don't have enough space to work with the plane, so I had to use the scraper a little bit more than I expected. Anyway, the instrument starts looking a bit like it should, and I like it a lot, to be honest. That's it for today's video. Many thanks to the Patreons once again for supporting the channel. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the upcoming videos, and also use the bell icon to get a notification, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!